Hi friends, welcome back to Angular Hero to Superhero series. If you are a beginner trying to learn Angular, there is another series, Angular Zero to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. You can find the link in the description. In this Angular series, Hero to Superhero, I am focusing on advanced concepts. In this video, I am going to explain how we can integrate NG2 charts in Angular. Let's start. A chart is a graphical representation for data visualization. We have different types of charts like line chart, bar chart, pie chart, etc. In JavaScript, we have a library called Chart.js. Using that, we can implement charts in our applications. In Angular, we have NG2 charts. NG2 charts is the Angular directives for Chart.js. I'm going to explain how we can integrate that and implement different charts in our application. For that, I have created this Angular application. I have created the needed components, applied CSS, and completed routing also. Okay. First, let's install NG2 charts. Let me open the NPM site. Here they are giving two options. First one is using schematics. I tried that, but for some reason it didn't work in my system. I got some errors. So for this demo, let me use the second option to manually install NG2 charts library. And then Chart.js library. Okay, both are installed. Now we need to import the ng charts module in our root module. After that, let me open the line chart component. I'm going to plot the sales percentage against days in a week. Let me create the chart data object using labels and datasets. Inside datasets, I can have an object with data and a label. This label is going to be the dataset label. In the HTML, let me create a canvas with width 600 and height 400. To this canvas, I need to add the base chart directive. As I am going to create the line chart, I can specify the type as line. And then let me bind the line chart data with the data attribute. That's it. We can see the chart now. We can also customize our chart. Right now, this is not filled. If I want to fill it, I can specify that in the datasets. Fill true. Now we can see our chart is filled. In case, if I want to change this fill color, I can specify a background color. If I want to change the border color, I can mention that too. You can see our line chart is in straight line. If I want to change that to curve, I can specify a tension value. Now it is curved. Like that, we have many options. We can check that in this documentation and customize according to our requirement. Okay, let's move to bar chart. For bar chart also, I can use the same data. So let me copy this and change it to bar chart data. And we don't want these options. Let me remove it. In HTML, let me copy this canvas and let me change this variable name. And I need to change the type to bar. And let me change the background color. Okay, bar chart looks good now. Here also, we can check the documentation to customize further if needed. Next, pie chart. Let me use the same data. And let me also copy the canvas code and change the variable name and chart type. Okay, our pie chart looks very big. To fix this, let me add a chart option. Responsive false. Now we can change this canvas width and height to fit our pie chart inside our container. And for pie chart, we can give some background colors to change these colors. Let me give some colors. Okay, looks good. Finally, we can implement donut chart. Donut chart is exactly similar to pie chart. So let me quickly copy the data on HTML. And the only change is, I need to specify the type as donut. And using the cutout property, we can change the cutout size of the donut chart. Hope you understood how we can use NG2 charts in our application. Please like this video, subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.